What you do need is to have them separated digesters down for each part of the building. Constructors of simple on-site biodegradable toilet waste biodigesters right here in Ghana. Today, we are outside Accra in the Eastern region, basically constructing biodigesters for a family of great property where everything is for sustainable use of the homeowners. In this video, I'm going to show you how we went about it.
My name is Landon Bodley. So we've been here about six, seven months now. We love it out here. It's a really beautiful country. And a Brie, of course, it's beautiful place out here.
So, exactly.
Yeah, we really like, you know, being off grid, so to speak. So, And the first time I saw a Brie, it just like, man, that's a beautiful place in the mountains. Here we have basically a four-bedroom home that sits on basically 3.5 plots. Three bedrooms with a helper's quarters in the back. We got enough yard in the backyard that we can plant. And that's what we wanted to do. We're gonna do some planting in the back, but then we're gonna do a actual garden in the very back. So it's just so we can grow enough crop, you know, to kind of live off, and at the same time, we plan on getting chickens back here. Yeah. So,
wow.
Yeah.
That's great.
You know, this is kind of like getting back to our roots. You know, both me and my wife grew up with our grandparents, both had farms, you know, growing up, and they raised their own chickens. They grew their own food. And so we wanted to come back here and get back to the same thing. So we got a lot of learning to do. Right.
For the biodigesters, we did two family size standard biodigesters on each side of the building. Because the rooms are four, we divided them into two. Did one digester and one at the other side of the property. What we were trying to do in this case is to make sure that no matter the situation, there's always an added advantage of having another biodigester available in the house. What happens is most people always say that they would prefer to have two digesters, and then if there's a problem, at least there will be one digester that the family can be using for the main time. So we just went by that one, and then instead of doing one large family size digester and adding a soakaway to it, we decided to divide the biodigesters into two and then give each one of them a simple small size traditional soakaway. We also did a traditional soakaway for the kitchen, the bathroom, and the laundry rooms at all. We brought it all the way out to the gate by the corner of the building with the hope that one day, if they do have a gutter in front of the house, then we can connect it. Or there will be an overflow pipe that will be attached to it, that will be connected into the drainage system or into the gutter. What you should also do in this situation is to give it an access by putting a clean out on the soakaway so that you can always have access to it. Worst case scenario, and it's not working effectively, you can have a small pump and have it pumped out. You give it a clean out, and that's what we decide to do now for all the projects. I mean, if you have realized over the years, we insist on having a clean out on each digester and soakaway that we do. It makes it easier for future use. If the whole place is covered, at least you know that there's something that you can always have access to. If you are considering constructing a biodigester for your dream house, there are a few key tips you have to consider. You can consider a large size digester plus a traditional soakaway just for the whole building, or you can decide to have them in smaller units depending on how far apart they are from each other. So if you have a burden, and then the problem will become that the biodigester's depth is not that much. So it means that you need to have enough gradient for the digester to come and hit the base in terms of the inlet where you have the biodegradable material working from. So in that situation, what you do need is to have them separated, have separate digesters down for each part of the building. On the other side, if you have a slope and it's going to one side and that's where the digester is going to be placed, then the better for you. One large digester will work in that situation. You have it done, and then you attach the traditional soakaway to it. You get it? So that's what should be done. The traditional soakaway is what changes the whole mindset for the wastewater management in your compound. So even in this particular digesters, we even had to consider that same mindset. But it was done with the mindset that the soil is good, so we are going to just construct a small size traditional soakaway for it. And then knowing that the number of users in the facility is not that much, right? And then the toilets are being divided. Two toilets are taking one digester. Then obviously it's going to be less usage or less pressure on one particular digester at any given point in time. The biodigesters, we are using the prefabricated slabs. The space that we need, we prefer the prefabricated slabs. Have them erected nicely and do the inside filtration bed and the bedding material. The key for this digester is to make sure that the water is getting away from the digester itself. Luckily for us, we met a good sand, so the soil is good, so it's going to soak well. So we are doing those two biodigesters, 6x2 dimension, and we are connecting it to a traditional small size soakaway. This simple on-site biodegradable biodigesters work well in all situations. Just like how any system will work, they also work in that form. The difference is that these digesters actually manage your human waste at your own backyard. The traditional systems of septic tanks and manholes would have just hold your human waste in a tank, and then with time you need a truck to have it taken out to a waste treatment plant for it to be treated. Not with this technology, everything is being treated at your backyard for easy disposal in the backyard itself. So tissue paper is biodegradable and the human waste itself is biodegradable. That's why they have become one of the best game changers when it comes to solid waste management right here in Ghana. Channel, we do videos that explains how biodigesters work and how you can use them as a homeowner in managing the human waste in your dream house.